these are Japanese shoes for my friend. Shout out to Kotemaru. You know, all this, by the way. We like traveling, so I've been to Japan to my friend. And
it's so funny because I'd given strict instructions, no showing legs.
No, I'm not shy. Like, I like my legs. I don't care. Like, watch these fingers go.
VIP Access is coming to you this week from the Village Creative. I'm about to interview a Czech Angolan superstar who's not just an artist, but he's also a sportsman. He's into jiu-jitsu just like my husband. He comes from the same country with my husband, same town, but it's not really about that. He's in Kenya recording music. Welcome, Benny Cristo. How are you?
Hi, how are you?
I'm good.
Thank
Welcome
you so much.
To my town.
Thank you so much for having me. That's awesome.
Oh, it's so awesome to have you here. Karibu Kenya. We say that to mean welcome to Kenya.
Thank you so much. This is awesome.
Yeah? So how are you feeling? How long have you been here? Have you ever been, you know, to Kenya or to other African countries? You know, what are the vibes so far?
Yo, so I was supposed to be here only for 1 week with my producer working on a track actually for Eurovision. You know, like just to give it like an African vibe and stuff, but then I kind of fell in love with the culture, fell in love with the city, with the people and stuff, so I extended my flight because it's just been awesome, like from people to fruit to just, you know, like parties and stuff. The vibe is just it's crazy in here.
Fantastic.
It really is the first time that I'm in sub-Saharan Africa. I've only been to like Egypt, and I don't really count it as the kind of like part of my origin because it really is far away in terms of culture. So this is the first time that I've been here ever since I was 4, so that's 28 years since I've been to Africa. And like instantly the people, the rhythms, like everything that has been played in the clubs is just something that I can instantly vibe with, and I feel so home in this sense.
From music to sports, it's actually such a huge accomplishment to have the success that you've had so far. So I just want you to tell me about the sport and the music. You know, were you always in love with the two? And you know, where is your heart?
Yeah, I'm a musician full time. Like, I've been doing it for more than 10 years now, and it's been going well. But at the same time, you know, like it gets repetitive, it gets frustrating. Like, there's just a lot of stuff that you deal with on a regular basis, and you want to get out of it. You know, so I started doing martial arts, specifically Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, like your husband. It's so different that it's super important for my music, right? Because like I do my shows, I do everything and stuff, but then I go to trainings and there's a master who's 10 times better. There's so many people that can choke you out at any time. And it gives you humbleness, it gives you respect, you know, it gives you motivation, it gives you, you know, like order into your life, like a lot of things that music will never give you, you know, because music is wild, you know, like you meet people, you know, artists, you've been around artists, you know, like, especially artists that, like, know they're good, you know, the ego, like, shoots out, and then it's very hard to catch yourself.
So in other words, jiu-jitsu actually keeps you grounded.
Oh, hell yes, exactly. It's like my meditation. So it's very important for me. A lot of people ask me like, yo, how can you do this and this? Because I'm competing in jiu-jitsu. I have a World Cup coming, you know, like I really work on it hard. It's super important. It's my yin yang, you know. Like throughout my life, I've been told a lot of times, and I think many people have been told it, like you're supposed to do it, you know, like one thing, focus on it, like, and you're this guy, and you're like, you are a builder, you are a musician, you are a lawyer and stuff. And I think like everybody should have, you know, something that they love, and then something that they're, you know, interested in, something that they could vibe with. But I've been doing music for like, this is my 11th year coming, and you know, I've been very blessed. Like, I have a lot of amazing people that like what we do and stuff, so it's been awesome. Like, as an artist, you always want to grow somewhere. Like, there's just two ways. Like, either you get comfortable, or you actually like work on it and you like want to grow. So I've been doing music mainly for like 2 countries so far in Europe, and like being exposed to the market of Europe, people show me so much love.
Really?
You know, because I actually did an Afro pop song, you know, so
Ke Mama.
Ke Mama, yeah, exactly.
I love it.
Ke Mama. And so, like we've been working on it here in Nairobi, Kenya, and like the vibe is just so cool. I love it. I just love the process.
So tell me about your mama. Has she always been supportive of your career? Did she, you know, think that her son is gonna, you know, reach where you have reached today? Was it even a vision?
My mom, like, when we were growing up as kids, she had to take care of us for a long time just herself, like me and my sister. So like, we didn't have much money and stuff. It was a little bit of struggle, you know, to be honest. So my mom just wanted us to be successful and, like, you know, make money and stuff to get out of the poverty that we were growing up in, you know. By the way, I remember when we were kids, my mom was like, all right, Bianca, my sister, you're gonna be the singer. Like, Ben, no singing, yeah? You be sports or you do business, you know? So like, throughout my life, I've been doing sports a lot. Then I transcend to business. And and I kind of like stuck in my head, like, you know, Ben, you're not gonna do music. You know, like my mom said that Bianca's gonna do music. You're not supposed to do music, you know? But then I was like 20 and I was like in this office, you know, for like 2 years already doing marketing, whatever, blah, blah, blah. And I was like my spirit is dying here. Like, I don't wanna be doing this. Like, can I please do something else? And I was just, so I tried it and it worked very well for me. I'm super proud of like my team and like.
Are you happy with this, with your discography? Should we expect a new album maybe in 2020?
I believe that an artist nowadays shouldn't release as much content unless that artist like desperately needs money and stuff and like needs to sell. And content will become something precious. Like, there's so much of content nowadays. You guys have, you know, like different streaming platforms and stuff. So it's like music is infinite. It's almost for free and it's like everywhere. So like, as an artist, like if you know you are special, if you know you have something else to give to people, spare it. Make it special. Make it you know, unique. And that's my approach. So I don't do much music. You know, I'm trying to do maximum one EP a year. But since I came here, I really fell in love with like this vibe and stuff, and I like already like connected with the DJs, with the producers and stuff. And I want to do an EP for this kind of market. I don't even know what is my market. I don't even know if somebody will like what I do, you know. But just like, I already like the market, and that's important. Like, I don't think I should like worry too much about like who
likes
me. No, you
shouldn't. I mean, you're talking to the right person. Yeah. I'll market you. I'll promote you. Don't worry.
That's it, then. Thank you so much. No, because like, I think the most important thing for an artist is to be willing and like happy to create some content for the market.
Exactly.
And I think it should be special because like, and I had so much pleasure here in Kenya that I would love to do music here for like for this market and for whatever market likes me. I don't know.
You know, you've come to a level of like a struggling artist to become top of the top. Like right now, every brand wants to associate with you, wants you to be their brand ambassador.
No. So as I said, thank you so much. This has been like already too much. As I said, like life's been good to me, and I've been blessed with many opportunities that turn into gold. Literally, like, I've been very blessed.
I would love to talk to you until the end, but I have to let you go because your producer is waiting for you.
Nice.
But before that, I just want to say I love your country, and you know, my husband is from Pilsen.
Yeah.
So I'll tell you the places I've been to and tell me where I should go, where I haven't been to. I've been to Pilsen, I've been to
Prague.
Yes, of course, because you land in Prague. I've been to Olomouc.
Amazing.
I've been to Maria Skelazne.
Wow, you even know. She remembers by the way, this is not a simple thing to remember. Like, Czech words are very like challenging.
Yeah, and then I want to go to Zlín because Bacha is really big here.
Yeah, I know.
So I want to go to the museum and see. So I'm planning to go to Zlín. Where else have I been to?
So
I want to go to Kalafi Vary. I haven't gone yet. So where else haven't I gone?
I think you pretty much covered it. Like, Kalafi Vary, you really have to go because it's very different from
Bruno.
You've been to Brno. Brno is like my favorite. Like, I'm from Prague. I live in Prague and stuff. But like, I travel to Brno all the time. It's like very cool people, chill and stuff. You mentioned Zlín, to go to Bacha's museum and stuff. Very, very cool. He's a innovative, creative genius. He has like a building, like his main building consists of like floors, and in every floor, like, he basically has an elevator, and that elevator is his office. And he like lands in any floor that he basically comes to. Like, he has his office there. So he comes to marketing, comes to finance, comes to every single part. And like, he controls it. It's very cool. It's a very cool thing.
Okay, cool. So thank you so much, Benny. It's been an honor to have you on VIP Access. We're capping up right here at Village Creative. We wish you all the best.
Thank you so much.
Karibu sana. Okay, I'll let you go.